Yeah, but what happens though, as we all know, is that there are police provocateurs turn up, or other provocateurs, perhaps in this case, if they weren't police, and they incite violence. I saw this down in Melbourne at the World Economic Forum outside the casino, where the police sort of brought out a couple of bikie type guys who were perhaps police anyway from the casino, and they basically started coming out, and it was a bit like being at the Coliseum, and it was just a scrap, and they were just trying to pull people out of the crowd and provoke people and get violence going. It was just out there, and of course the media would never cover that.
Again, just recalling back to the protests in Melbourne in the year 2000 on September the 11th, the protests were known as S11. There you had police-sanctioned false flag, if you will, violence. There was a scenario where the police were kind of around the edge of the base of the Crown Casino. There was quite a large gap, an area, a space between the line of police and where the protesters were. A couple of bikies came out through the police, bikie-looking guys. They didn't have police uniforms on. They went across this gap, and then they were trying to sort of taunt and get guys or even perhaps girls out and bash them in front of everyone. It worked a few times. They kind of got a few people who suckered for it out of the crowd, or they kind of went in there and pulled them out, and there was like a kind of this bashing going on in between the police line and in between where the protesters were. That's why I describe it as like being at the Coliseum. Of course, we all know that at protests, there can be people who turn up there, dickheads who are not police or agent provocateurs from government agencies who will commit violence and that sort of thing and damage property and all the rest of it. But that's beside the point. In these cases, what we have here is people from government agencies going in and committing violence. And the general public, of course, as usual, would be clueless. I'll now play a little bit of footage from Canada, where there was an old guy there and he picked out the, he actually called them out as police. I think there were three guys there that dressed up as anarchists, and also the anarchists were kind of pointing, guys who were dressed up as anarchists were kind of pointing to these guys also saying, you know, all the rest of it. And one of them had a rock, one of these police officers duped up, trying to incite violence, had a rock. And then the police got them down on the ground and their shoes all matched and all the rest of it. Basically, the police did a mock arrest on the police. Let's watch the clip. I'm cutting it down.
This is our line. This is for old guys, grandmothers, grandfathers. That is our line. Come on. It's our line. Bugger off to your line. This is our line. Put the rock down. Put the rock down. This is our line. You fucking cops, get out of town. Cops out of town.
They want us to be aggressive with them.
Hey, take your mask off. These three guys are cops, everybody. Put the rock down, cops.
Police!
Come on, let's see your faces!
Come on, police!
Come on,
hey.
Let's see your faces!
It's not gonna help. It's not gonna help.
Come on, cops!
Let them go another way. They won't beat them. This is our line, and we want the cops out of there.
cool now, man. They got their cops back.
Good job.
Moving in because
the black block is
moving.
Yeah. Did somebody get injured?
No, the three cops tried to had rocks and they were about to start a riot. Suck everybody in and the kids spotted them. I stepped in front of them, stopped them. Provocateurs with boulders, they wanted to create a riot.
They're
policemen. We asked them to take their mask off. They're cops.
And they were provoking. They were, so it would be an excuse for the police to move in, and we don't want that. So we're not protecting the police. We're stopping.
We got some peaceful protesters down there. We got to protect.
They're back in there. They crossed back into the police line.
No doubt due to the footage in this case, it forced the hand somewhat of both the CBC, a mainstream media outlet, and the police. According to a Canadian CBC News article, we can read, police said the three undercover officers were only at the protest to locate and identify non-peaceful protesters in order to prevent any incidences. But then we can read on, police came under fire Tuesday when a video surfaced on YouTube that appeared to show three plainclothes police officers at the protest with bandanas across their faces. One of the men was carrying a rock.